taking it out wide. Uganda. Mary again.
Caroline, I love the patience that is with the girls. The way they drive down the balls patiently, bring them close to the goal at the circle edge and feed Mary very well, because she has all the space and the holds that just needs the balls to get to her.
The voice of Uganda international Ruth Memi with us here.
Before the Wales game, the coach made two major changes, replacing wing attacker Nora Lunkuse, who is not feeling well, with Sarah Nachiunga, and shooter Christine Namulumba was replaced by defender Viola Singo.
I think we've seen some of the other international teams with tall timbers, they're very much stuck on the body, which draws a penalty count. So to see them off the body, to see them challenging, trying to confuse the space, right tactic from my perspective.
Yeah, potentially that was the undoing for South Africa against Jamaica.
Indeed.
Drawn into Janelle Fowler.
Shikrins came into the game with a winning mentality, thanks to Shafi Nalwanja for intercepting seven of World Games and Sarah Nachiungu for containing and controlling the game. In the first half of the game that ended 37-27 in favor of Shikrins, the coach made no changes in the starting seven until the second half. Mugerwa substituted Irene Yaru and Shadia Nasanga, Margaret Wagala with Lilian Achola, and Stella Nanfoka with Farida Kadondi.
Kito there, whipping that one off Wales. Great support for Uganda. Involved again. Just allows it to go over the top to Mary Chollop. Ooh. You and I both made that noise, Ruth. Gets there in the end. Mary Chollop, always an option. Miles.
Oh, beautiful straight line ball there from Yarrington to Rowe. She presented nice and early. And that's what you call pinpoint attacking.
So just swaying in the wind back towards Wales for the moment. A little closer, and I've got to reward some of this great work from the attacking end as Georgia Rowe makes it.
15 minutes towards the end of the game, Mugerwa pulled out Mary Nuba for Anisha Muhammad and Margaret Wagala also returned. Uganda's win against Wales was instrumental not only for securing a third placement in Group G, but also to consolidate Uganda's ranking. Wales is ranked before Uganda, and a defeat from them would have threatened our ranking.
The scoreline, Wales unable to do that at the moment.
Wales looking for their own double.
Uganda is ranked 8th, whereas Wales 9th, according to World Netball Rankings. Shafi Nalwanja was awarded player of the match of making 7 ball interceptions.
I think that it was our first time, it was good, but still there's an area that we need to work out, more especially for tomorrow's game. We need to work out some other things that what I have to do when it comes to that match.
You talk about malaria. Margaret has probably been the best player for Uganda from the first game. What are the chances that she'll be available tomorrow?
Yeah, she's receiving treatment, and in fact, yeah, even up now, right now, as we go, she's going to take maybe her last dose. And we hope that by tomorrow she will be fully recovered. And that was maybe the reason why we substituted her, because she was feeling dizzy because of the drugs and maybe the medicine she's taking. But I think by tomorrow she'll be recovered.
What's your take, first of all, on your performance in a position one would say you're not familiar with? But you managed to put up the performances from day one in wing defense.
Well, I think being the first time playing in defense, I think I'm not so bad. I've been consistent since the first game, and I've been waiting for this chance to be player of the match. And being player of the match on a very good team, Wales is a very good team, it feels really, really great.
Well, just like many of the players out there are playing at your first World Cup, how is the experience?
So far, not so bad, because we've only lost 2 games. and although we lost, we put up a good fight. So far, it's a very good start for me.